This is the sound of 6 inches of water flowing over the roads that lead to Mike Odegaard's Hoge Island home. There's a similar depth of water that still covers his front yard leading up to the foot of a massive 8-foot dike. Where there was once a driveway, Odegaard uses a Polaris Ranger to go through the water, only to have to climb up and down the steps of the dike to get to his front door.
I've been flooded in Grand Forks. So my dike didn't work there. So this time, I just need to go bigger, wider.
For most of May, Odegaard was preparing for a typical summer.
Up until the 23rd, there was no one. There was landscape in the pool. You know what I mean? There is no hint that they were going to go 150 at all this spring.
Though his house now looks more like a fortress, Odegaard, like so many flood victims, had little time to prepare.
Imagine packing this house in from upstairs to outside in 6 hours and find places to put it all. This was probably your panic days right in here, the 27th and 28th, I don't remember back, that conference. That's a huge jump. My biggest fear right here was it couldn't be high enough in time.
Odegaard said he still questions the Corps' decisions.
I was thinking, how could they get this so wrong in a week to go from some increased flows to major flooding? Something got in the way of flood control.